Here's a quick update. No, sort of update. It's Thursday the 3rd of November. We've got one more cider day planned. It's probably about another 400 kilos there. I'd say about 100 kilos of Bramleys and 100 kilos of off one other particular tree, and then maybe four or five of different other types, maybe 10, 15 kilos of each. We're going to try and do those this weekend, but as you can see now, it is raining. And from what I'm led to believe, on Saturday, it's at best going to rain in the morning and be cloudy in the afternoon, and on Sunday it's going to be cloudy in the morning and drizzle in the afternoon or something similar. So I think we're going to have to get a gazebo and put everything together. We've got those three are full, or a lot's full. These are new. I got a load of second-hand barrels from DB Fuels this year, but in the end they were just so in such a state I couldn't really use them, so it was a bad buy and not really worth it. Now these are from a local supplier. They're clamp top barrels, which I don't like. I wanted screw tops like these, but they seem to be unicorns at the moment, so a little bit thin on the ground. Nice thing about the screw tops is I don't use airlocks. I just screw the lids down fully and then back it off a quarter of a turn. That acts like an airlock, and you can actually kind of tighten it down and let the pressure build, and it makes the top bulge, and you can actually kind of keep an eye on what kind of gas it's producing and the kind of rate of the fermentation, because of how much and how quickly the top bulges. And after a day or two you can just slightly unscrew it and you'll hear a hiss like you're opening a pressurized container, and it just lets the gas off, and then you just tighten it again, so it, you know, it keeps it tight and it keeps all the rest of the stuff out. And essentially now all these three of the primary fermentation's done on them, really, so there's very little CO2 coming out of them now, so they're actually mainly screwed shut, I'd say, for 2 days and opened every couple of days. And we're gonna decant a couple of those into those and essentially clamp them shut and watch the lids expand, and then just check and make sure we don't actually make them blow up. And then we're gonna sort of on Saturday fill another one of those full of cider, and I'm gonna shut this now because it's really starting to rain. So yeah, and I haven't really said anything about the garden, but obviously the patio's finished and we're principally down in some wind, and you can see I've started putting the fence back together, so hopefully this time next year I won't have to think about doing any of the gardening. I can actually think about doing more cider stuff. That's it, signing off.